الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. عبد الرحمن كم تسأل؟
We're reading in chapter Sujood al-Sahwi. The Sujood you make if you make a mistake in the Salah. Okay? And I'm just a quick reminder because some people would not hear. The first hadith is when the Prophet stood up from the second rak'ah, from Sujood immediately without doing tashahud in the middle. And at the end of the Salah, he made two sajda, and then he made salam. Two sajda, not without tashahud after that. You already made your tashahud. Before you make your salam, you make sujood, you get up, you make sujood, and it is as long as the sujood was salah. You make salam. Of course, scholars say that Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yani made him forget these parts of the salah. For what reason? To teach us. Teach people. This never happened. There's more than one forgetfulness. This is one of them. This is one incident where he forgot. And there's another one in the next hadith. This is to teach the people. And the second hadith was when the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam prayed the Dhuhr prayer. It is the Dhuhr prayer. Two rak'at instead of the four rak'at. I think I said Asr prayer last time. It is Dhuhr prayer. Two rak'at instead of four, and he did not know he had prayed two. That is clearly Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made him forget, because everyone else knew that he only made two salah, two rak'at, and he was the only one who thought he did four. So when people ask him, did you deliberately shorten the salah ila qasr for some reason, or did you forget? He said, I did not forget, and I did not make it short. So he was sure he did four, subhanallah, but it was two. So when he was sure, يعني ولم يسجد حتى يقنه الله, until he was sure only, حتى يقنه الله تعالى ذلك, then he gave two more rak'at. And then he made sujood after the ruku'. No. In this hadith, when he forgot and he made the salah for the two rak'at instead of four, the narrator of the hadith mentions that he looked as if he was upset. After he finished, he sat and he had his back on a pole in the masjid. He looked as if he was upset, and people were afraid to talk to him for a short while, even though they knew that something happened in the salah, but they were afraid to ask him. Because when you look and find someone upset, you don't want to go and talk to him at that point, right? Scholars say that, why was he upset? They say this is a sign from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the believer in general, that when we have deficiencies in what we're doing, in our obligation towards Allah, or when we commit sins, and this always causes some kind of internal distress and upset. And that is a good sign, because this is always a good sign. It only happens to the believer. من سبته حسنته وسأته معصيته فهو مؤمن. Whenever you feel happy when you do good, hasana, righteousness, and you feel sad and upset when you do ma'asiyah, sin, then you are a believer. So this is always a sign. And sometimes you don't even know that you did something wrong, but you get the feeling, and that feeling tells you, what am I doing wrong? And that is always a reminder from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is something wrong that you have to correct now. Now, someone asked last time, what if there's, where does he do sujood before or after? Do it before or after the salah is sahiha. If he did it before or after. If you can't remember where to do it before, where to do it after. The question is, where is it preferred to do, before or after, in what situation? But is it correct to do it before or after? It's always correct to do it before or after. No one can tell you you've done something wrong. قال القاضي عياض, لا خلاف بين العلماء أنه لو سجد بعد السلام أو قبله للزيادة أو للنقص أنه يجزئه ولا تفسد صلاته. نعم, وإنما اختلافهم في الأفضل.
The only difference amongst them, the scholars, where is the best place to do some sujood? Before,
here's the opinion of some scholars. Imam Abu Hanifa says, it is always after salam.
So whatever, if you have to do the sujood itself, you do it after
salam, always.
It's easy to remember. The Shafi'iyya, it's always before salam. It is always before salam. Okay, it's their opinion. But the hadith indicate that he did it before and he did it after. So that's why you're never wrong if you do it before or after. Now,
some scholars said, if it was due to a deficiency in the salah, it is before the salam.
Like when he forgot the tashahud in the middle. That was something deleted from the salah. That is before. But if there's an addition, like when he made salam and he made full tashahud and salah al-Ibrahimiyyah and he made salam, then he added two rak'at, there's an addition to the salah, he made it after. That's another way to remember it. Now,
should he do tashahud after? Imam Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah says, at-tashahud ba'da sajdatayhi saw, lam yarid fihi shay. لم يرد فيه أي شيء من أقوال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا أفعاله وعمدة من يراه حديث غريب ليس له متابع وهذا يوهي الحديث ويضعفه.
So do you do تشهد after? The stronger opinion is that you don't do. But if someone did it, he's not wrong. Why is that? Because of this hadith here. And Imran bin Husayn رضي الله تعالى عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم صلى بهم فسهد فسهى فسجد 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 سجدتين ثم تشهد ثم سلم. The same hadith of Dhul Yadayn, when he did the two rak'at instead of four, Imran ibn Husayn reports the same hadith and he says, Prophet ﷺ, after he did the two more rak'at to complete his salah, he made the sujood, then he made tashahud, then he made salam. Okay. The addition of making tashahud, أما لفظ ثم تشهد فقد قال ابن سيرين لم أسمع بالتشهد شيئا وضعفها البيهقي وابن عبد البر وقال ابن المنذر لا أحسب التشهد في سجود السهو يثبت وقال كثير من المحققين أنه ليس فيه ذكر التشهد وإنما انفرد به أشعث ابن عبد الملك الحمراني وقد خالف غيره من الحفاظ فهو شاذ.
So doing تشهد after, only one man reported this. And all the other people who reported this hadith never said that Prophet ﷺ did tashahud. Which means it's probably a mistake from that one person. And this is one of the ways to know if this addition of tashahud was correct or not correct. It's a mistake, everyone makes mistakes. And he's one of the people who narrated the hadith. So if you have 10 people telling you, Prophet ﷺ did sujood and then salam. And you find one person saying, he did sujood, tashahud then salam. Which one do you go with? You go with the rest of the people. Now, and this addition, then we call it ziyada shadda, meaning it is odd. This whatever he reported is odd. It does not go in harmony with the rest of the people who mentioned this hadith. But if someone does it based on this hadith, we cannot tell him your salah is not correct. It's up to him, but tell him it is a weak opinion because everybody who narrated the hadith never mentioned tashahud. وصحيح الحديث صريح بأنه أتى التشهد بعد سجدتي السهو وهو مذهب طائفة من أهل العلم وهو المشهور من مذهب الحنابلة والمالكية. مالكية and حنابلة أحمد بن حنبل and his followers and Imam Malik, they say you do تشهد after سجود السهو based on this hadith, but as we said it is a weak addition, so better the stronger opinion is not to make تشهد after سجود السهو. Question about this?